Hi, I am Dr. Goodmanson with a rapid derivation video intended for the readers of my book, General Aviation Aircraft Design, Applied Methods and Procedures. In this video, I will show you a fast way to derive the famous Archimedes Principle. The principle is mentioned in Appendix C of the second edition, but space constraints precluded it from being derived. Consider some liquid of density rho in an acceleration field of strength g. Further assume we have established an average surface to which we reference all dimensions. Then suppose we submerge a massless cylinder of diameter d and height h in the liquid. A cylinder is not required, but makes things simpler because of its elementary geometry. For one, the surface area of the top and bottom surfaces is given by the simple expression shown in the diagram. Area A is equal to pi times d squared divided by 4. A massless cylinder is also a simplification that will be addressed at the end of the video. It should be clear that the pressure force acting on the vertical side of the cylinder results in zero net lateral force. This holds for all shapes. If this were not true, the cylinder would move sideways in the liquid. The same does not hold for the pressure forces acting on the top and bottom surfaces. Assume the top surface is submerged at distance h1 below the average surface, and the bottom surface at distance h2. First consider the top surface. The pressure acting on it is given by the hydrostatic pressure equation as shown here. This equation is derived in the video Hydrostatic Pressure in Liquids. Thus, the pressure force F1 acting on the top is the product P1 times A, as shown here. This can be expanded using the diameter of the cylinder as shown. Note that the pressure force always points perpendicular to a surface. Here, this means that F1 points downward. Similarly, consider the bottom surface. The pressure acting on it is rho gh2. Thus, the pressure force F2 acting on the bottom is P2 times A. This pressure force points upward in a direction opposite of F1. Thus, the difference between forces F1 and F2, denoted by delta, is given by... Inspecting the two force equations shows that the magnitude of F2 is greater than F1 because the magnitude of H2 is greater than H1. This means that delta is the net vertical force acting on the cylinder that pushes it upward toward the surface of the liquid. Delta is the buoyancy force. Substituting our parameters leads to, then simplifying yields. Now note that the difference h2 minus h1 is the height of the cylinder h, and the product of the height h and the area A is the volume of the cylinder, here denoted by V strike through. Therefore, the buoyancy force is given by rho g V strike through. And the Archimedes principle is the expression shown below. Once we understand how the buoyancy is generated, there are frequently two questions that arise. First, what if the immersed body is not a cylinder, but something like these? Let's say the body is a cone. If submerged, such its base is horizontal, the resulting pressure distribution is uniform and generates a vertical force that points upward. Along the slanted wall, the pressure reduces toward the top. If we inspect the force on the slanted wall, we see it can be split into a horizontal and vertical component. The vertical component points down. If immersed in this orientation, the same happens. This is a law of nature that only depends on rho, g, and the volume of the displaced liquid. The second question is, what happens if the cylinder's mass, m, is not zero? This applies to all real applications and requires a force balance to be evaluated. Here, for instance, for the static case, the sum of all forces acting on the cylinder must equal zero. In the vertical direction, this means that F2 minus F1 minus mg must equal zero. In other words, delta minus mg is zero. Thus, if mg is greater than delta, the body will descend to a greater depth. and if mg is less than delta, the body will ascend to the surface.